Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to the United States Naval War College graduation ceremony for the Naval War College Command and Staff online program for the fall quarter class of 2020. I am Professor Walt Wildeman, and I am the Dean of the Naval War College's College of Distance Education, the college under which the program is organized and administered, and I am your MC for today. As some in the audience know, this is the first in what will be many quarterly graduations for our online program. We decided to conduct quarterly virtual graduation exercises because we want to recognize our online program graduates in both a more timely and more specific manner. Therefore, we will recognize the graduates with this virtual ceremony in which everyone is encouraged to use the chat feature and the clapping hand icon to congratulate the graduates throughout the ceremony. As a final note, I'd ask the graduates to let your professors know what you think about the ceremony as we welcome your suggestions on any ways that we might improve on it for future classes. Thank you. And now it is my distinct honor to introduce Rear Admiral Shoshana S. Chatfield, 57th President of the United States Naval War College. Admiral Chatfield.
Good afternoon. I know many of you may not be in a good afternoon kind of a place, so good morning or good evening to those of you who aren't. To our distinguished visitors, we don't know where you are, but we are thankful that you are watching today in this virtual format. Thank you for joining us. We hope one day to welcome you warmly to Newport. I'd like to acknowledge Mr. George Lang, who is here online and representing our Naval War College Foundation. Thank you and your organization for your continuing and incredible support of the college over these years. Our students, our faculty, and our staff have benefited tremendously from your contributions, and so has our Navy and our nation. To Dean Wildeman and Professor Sexton, thank you for inviting me and getting this organized, our first of many quarterly graduations. To our acting provost, our deans, our faculty and staff, you inspire me. You've set the standards of educational excellence in learning, research, and operational experience. You anticipate the needs of our students and their agencies, and today you see before you the fruits of your labor. Your efforts in educating and developing these leaders will pay dividends in their contributions to our Navy, our nation, and our national security in the future. Thank you for your dedication and for your service. Now, to the family and friends of today's graduates, thank you for participating. You can use the chat box and the icons to give some claps and to cheer on your graduates. We know that you've made sacrifices too. You've enabled your student to study, to read, to reflect, to write those papers, and you've enabled their successful completion of this program. I thank you for that. Your continued encouragement is critical to their future success, and I know that you will continue to support these graduates. So I want to thank you for all of the patience, particularly through these moments of uncertainty and change over the past few months, and for your continuing and unwavering support. And now to the graduates of the Naval Command and Staff online program. I want to take a moment to recognize the incredible amount of extra effort that you have put forward in the evenings, on weekends, to complete your classes, the research, and the writing and reading. your investment that you chose to make in your own education is also an investment in our Navy and our nation. The effort that you put forward to succeed is admirable. You sacrificed a great deal in your personal lives to take advantage of this education opportunity. And for that, I commend you. And on behalf of my boss, the Chief of Naval Operations, I thank you. Through the course of your study, you were charged to think critically, to analyze, to strategize, and to innovate. You were tasked to study through a lens of diplomacy and ethics, a lot of subjects like history, strategy and policy, operational art, diplomacy. And through that same lens, you were asked to tackle the myriad challenges that lie ahead for our great nation. Together, drawing from your diverse backgrounds and professional paths, each of you answered that call. You challenged your faculty, you challenged yourselves, you answered these questions, and you've emerged as scholars, 211 strong this quarter. You should be rightfully proud of your accomplishments. Now, if we've learned anything over the past 7 months, it's that the future is always filled with unpredictability and possibly momentous changes. The final half year of your study was punctuated by a global pandemic and a deep questioning of social justice facing Americans and our American government, an examination of our commitment to the universal values of equality, personal freedom, access to prosperity, and fair treatment under the law. And you've seen once again our rugged and tenacious commitment to freedom of expression, freedom of speech, and the American dream. And that commitment has been heard and acknowledged around the world. It is the reality of an ever-changing world that this new reality contains with it the need for educated officers. In fact, our senior leaders view learning as a key strategic enabler. And that enabler will guarantee the success of our national defense. Your personal investment in your education is a direct contribution to our U.S. Navy warfighting advantage. Your charge now is to commit to the transformative power of education and to link what you've just learned to how we fight, to how you will frame problems, and how you will develop and assess solutions in the future, how you will build winning teams. This is just one part of the continuum of learning throughout your careers, and you must invest your energy and continue your development for yourself and for those you lead. Do not ever be content to sit comfortably smack dab in the middle of your own subject matter expertise. Always press to the edges. Seek opportunities to collide with the intellects of others whose specialties and experience and viewpoints differ from yours. There is where you will find and develop innovative ideas, which are the key to our future success. Take with you what you learned here, how to think through a different lens, to view the challenges that you will inevitably face in the future. You are duty bound to take your strengthened intellect, your improved analytical skills, and your expanded perspective, and use those to be the leader that you will become. To all of the graduates today, you join a large and yet distinguished group of U.S. Naval War College alumni, a group whose membership spans nearly 136 years. I challenge you to continue the growth and success that you started at the Naval War College through participation in our alumni communities. Please stay connected with each other. Please stay connected with our joint partners, and please stay connected with us. I thank you again, and I thank your families and your support networks for taking the time to sit with us and celebrate you. 211 new graduates, congratulations.
Rear Admiral Chatfield, I now have the honor to present the United States Naval War College's Naval Command and Staff Online Program Fall Quarter Class of 2020. They have been thoroughly examined and approved by the faculty.
By the power vested in me, by the Congress of the United States, the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and the New England Commission of Higher Education, I confer upon you the College of Naval Command and Staff Diploma and Joint Professional Military Education Phase 1 certification from the United States Naval War College with all of the honors, rights, and privileges pertaining thereto.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in saluting in the chat room and with the hand clap, the graduates of the United States Naval War College Fall Class of 2020 and their families. Thank you. Congratulations, graduates. You all should be rightfully proud. We now have a special guest who would like to acknowledge and congratulate the graduates as well.
Greetings from the Pentagon. I'm Vice Admiral Lisa Franchetti, Deputy Chief of Naval Operations for Warfighting Development, better known as OPNAV N7. This new directorate is designed to deliver warfighting advantage to our Navy, in part by developing people like you to lead our service to victory in the future fight, whatever shape that fight takes on. Congratulations on this accomplishment. You should all be very proud of everything you've achieved, and I hope you're excited and ready to apply and build upon what you've learned during the course of this program. As a fellow graduate of the Naval War College's distance education program, I know how hard it is to complete these academics while working full-time and balancing all the other aspects of your life. Thank you for making this effort. You and our Navy will be better and stronger because of it. As this chapter of learning comes to an end, let me leave you with one thought. Oliver Wendell Holmes once said, and I'm paraphrasing, "Every now and then a person's mind is stretched by a new idea and never shrinks back to its former dimension." I hope the War College has indeed stretched your mind and you continue to take the time to read, study, and build on what you've learned. For us to have what it takes to win in the future, we need you to do that. Again, congratulations on achieving this important milestone in your development as a Naval officer. I wish you, your families, and your support networks all the best in the future and hope to see you in the fleet one day.
Thank you, Admiral Chatfield, for your inspirational remarks and your charge to the graduates. And thank you for arranging for Admiral Franchetti's appearance as well. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce the Naval War College Director of Alumni Programs, Professor Julia Gage. Julia.
Thank you, Dean. Welcome all of our newest graduates. It's very exciting. Congratulations. Welcome to the Alumni Network. You're in excellent company. And I heard Admiral Chatfield's charge to all of you, and certainly a charge to me. And don't worry, we're not leaving you alone out there. The War College is committed to your lifelong learning and your professional development. And the hub for all of this is myusnwc.com. There you will find a plethora of interesting articles, videos, things going on at the college, news about your classmates, all kinds of great content. But the real value, and I was just looking at this morning, 84% of everyone that registers for the myusnwc.com chooses to be a mentor and chooses specific ways that they want to help the community. And I think we should all be really proud of that, that statistic. It really shows the quality of the alumni network that you're all joining today. And so thank you so much for your already great investment in our beloved institution. And please do join us on myusnwc.com. And on behalf of our over 50,000 alumni, welcome and congratulations and good luck.
Thank you, Julia. We in the College of Distance Education are very happy and proud that we were able to add 211 more graduates to your alumni database. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. Best wishes for a nice day and a celebratory weekend ahead. Thank you for attending.